Good morning, good morning. Come on in and answer that Do Now question. What qualities, skills, or perspectives are unique to young people? And go ahead and fill it in the chat below. Good morning, good morning. Come on in and answer that Do Now question. What qualities, skills, or perspectives are unique to young people? What do you guys do differently than old people don't do? And how does that make a difference? Good morning, good morning. Come on in. And answer that Do Now question. What qualities, skills, or perspective, your thought and mind, that are unique to young people that are different than maybe how I think? What's different about you? Come on in and answer today's Do Now question. What qualities, skills, or thoughts of mind are unique to young people? Stand up for your right. Get up, stand up. Remember, we're talking about activism. So what do you think that you guys do better than we might do? Typing in your answer below. Good morning, good morning. Today's Do Now is on the wall. Already. What qualities, skills, or perspectives are unique to young people? What do you think you guys do better than we do? Good morning. Come on in and answer today's Do Now question. Most people think great God will come from the sky. Take away everything. Good morning. Make everybody feel high. But if you know what life is worth, you would look for yours on earth. And now when you see the light, you stand up for your rights. Yeah, get up. Good morning. Come on in and answer that Do Now question. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Come on in.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Susan.
Can't hear you.
I just had a conversation with a student, so I just want to say, do my public service.
Can't hear.
While you are answering, listen.
The quarter just cut the music off then.
Friday. Third quarter ended Friday.
I can't hear you.
You can't hear me?
Nope.
I don't even know where my earphones are.
Thank you. Good morning, good morning, good morning. When you're coming in, please come on in.
Morning, can you hear me now?
Creativity that you guys have differently than everybody else. The Realist Bree, I'm going to be dealing with that in just a little bit, okay? So let's stick to what the focus is, which is the lesson. Thank you. I'm writing down some of these names, Mr. T. Okay. Kind of.
No, I was saying that the quarter ended, you all. The quarter ended Friday. We are now in quarter four. So, some of you know, you all know what your grades were. We don't have to go through what your grades were and all of the other things. But you know that if you have not done the work that you needed to do for quarters one and two, the third quarter was important to you. We are now in quarter four. That is important to you. Please make sure that you all turn in the work that we have assigned you. It's great that you are here, and you get credit for being here and for participating. But you have got to turn the work in. I am not getting a lot of work. I know Ms. Radden and I are sharing, so maybe you're sending some work to her, and that's fine. We will still share those grades with one another. Y'all have got to turn this work in. School is not over. I know we're doing this virtually, but you have got to turn in the work.
Good morning, good morning. I know who you are. You don't have to tell me. Good morning, Mr. Walker. Mr. T, if you'll do me a huge favor, if you'll speak up just a little bit louder, I can barely hear you on my end. I'm sorry. I'm straining. Again, only one person has answered my do now question. Testing.
Don't put your names up. We know who you are.
We know who you are.
If you want to send us your name, make sure that you all are sending us your names in DM.
Today's do now is in the box. I only have one person, and only one person is going to get a grade for do now. The question is, what qualities, skills, or perspective do you have that are unique to young people? I might not see it in somebody that's a little older. Please do not put your name in. We know who you are.
What's going on, y'all?
Okay, somebody said confidence. So I heard creativity. I heard confidence. Knowledge. That could be debatable. I'm writing down these names. Stamina. Hey, I like that. How about it? Well, there could be some knowledge. So DMV scope, there could be some knowledge that you all have that we don't have about a certain situation. And so we're going to talk about that in just a little bit. The way we adapt to change. Oh, how about it? Absolutely. Absolutely. All right. Coming in, answering this do now question. I have about another minute or so. Respectful. You dreams to believe. What do you, dreams to believe? You want to.
So, older people you don't think have dreams?
Respectful. That could be debatable from both sides.
Let's make sure. Let's read the question again. What qualities, skills, or perspectives are unique to young people?
I swear I can't hear him.
Can you all hear me? If you can hear me, give me a thumbs up. I'm not sure what's happening.
Some knowledge about a situation, the drive to keep going. Okay, I like that. Experience. That could be debatable. Some people can hear you, so that's good. As long as they can hear, I'm all right with it. So when we go to effort or friendship. Okay. Thank you guys so much for the thumbs up. It's just a little low on my end over here then. All right, and maybe in the playback it'll be a little differently. All right, well, good morning to everybody. Good morning, good morning, good morning. All right, if you did not get in on a Do Now question, I'm about to take it down because, again, this is quarter four. We're going to talk about those terms and expectation in just a second. Again, good morning to everybody. Good morning. I'm so happy to see all of you guys. You view things differently. I see that. Thank you so much. Absolutely. Absolutely. If your friends aren't here, tell your friends to come on and get in. All right. This is quarter four. So this is completely different. And we're going to talk about that and the expectations. All right. So let's go ahead and I'm going to go ahead and move forward in our things today because we have a lot to cover. All right. So we're looking at term four, expectations and goals. All right, and I know Mr. T would want to jump in here. He had started talking about it already, unbeknownst to him, that I was going to actually drop this slide in, which I did a little bit. Hope and youthfulness, okay? So, yeah, Golden Nugget came in. So let's just talk about term four. Last week ended the term on Friday, right? And so I told many of you guys last week, we were starting term four last week, and I meant exactly what I said when I said that. All right. So those of you all who are just coming in for the first time, thank you and welcome. But in order for you to get grades, it's going to be imperative that you come into these lives and participate in the lives because that is a grade. And then you're going to need to turn in the work. So let me just say this, that while you have the packets there, and I'm grateful for the packets, there are going to be some things that I'm going to go off script on, all right? And I'm going to make you aware what those things are. Like, for example, you guys had to do a poster, right? And that poster, believe it or not, was not a part of that packet at all, right? But that took the place or subbed the place for me with regard to looking at the objective summary. So while some people might have done the objective summary, the poster took the place of that. So we're not going to do a writing this time around. It's going to be something a little bit different. And that's why I need you guys focused on what it is that I'm doing. All right. Give me a thumbs up if you understand that expectation is going to look a little bit different this time. And you're going to have to really be following and paying attention. Thumbs up.
What I want to add to that, Ms. Radden, is that we don't have an endless amount of time to turn this work in. So we are going to turn in term three grades, and you're going to get a report card in about a week, right? A week and a half. Mm-hmm. So you all have got to turn in this term three work in order to actually get a grade for what you all have done. If you're sitting at home and you're sitting on papers and vocabulary and summaries that you have not turned in, how are we going to grade that? How are you going to get credit for that? You have to turn it in. So bring it to the school on Monday and Tuesdays. Submit it through Canvas. DM Ms. Radden or myself. Take a picture of it. And some of you all are doing it. Some of you are doing a good job of that.
Yep.
But there are many people who I see in here every week, and I have yet to see your work.
Absolutely. And that has affected tremendously term three grades look a little different. And like I said, just wanted to take an opportunity to go over that because whatever grade you kind of stopped with in the quarter, those grades will be what your final grade is. However, if you did do work from packets one, two, or three, those are what we consider extra credits, and those can boost your grade up to two letter grades. So if you've done the work, even though the term ended on Friday, you have until this Friday, May 1st, to turn in any work from packets one, two, and three. Now keep in mind, you can go ahead and turn that paperwork in at the school Monday and Tuesdays between the hours of 10 and 2, but you know you're online at 10 o'clock, so you don't need to be there at that time, but you can go after 11, right? But before 1, before you have your next class. Or you can go up to Baloo. Baloo is open Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m., Okay? So I just wanted to talk about those expectations. All of this work that we're doing right here is going into my quarter four grades. Okay? All right. So we're going to go ahead and get started for today. All right? And thank you guys so much. Again, participation is going to be key. If you're not participating, you will not get a grade for participation for today. You will get a zero. So please make sure you're writing in comments. Yeah, how you feel is how you feel, and I'm okay with that. I just want your voice to be heard so that you get the grade that you deserve. So here we go. All right. By the end of the lesson, students will be able to examine a real-world cause in order to propel the scholars thinking forward regarding their own cause and make their voices heard. All right? All right, so again, we're looking at a real-world cause. We've been talking about activism, and so I want to make sure, so we'll discuss that later. I want to make sure we are in packet four, all right, and we're still talking about activism, all right? So we're going to look at a real-world cause today, and I want you to take a look at the cause that you are standing up for, and I want you to be able to make some decisions. So with that being said, I need you to make sure you have a piece of paper, you have a pencil, something to write with, and you are in a quiet workspace. If you understood, thumbs up, please. Thumbs up if you are understanding that you need a piece of paper, a pencil, and a quiet space to work. I see a couple people coming in. Thumbs up. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. All right.
Very good, very good.
So let's go ahead and let's move forward really quickly. One of the causes I wanted to look at has a hashtag called Never Again. All right, Never Again. And this is the story behind of students rallying behind gun reform after a personal tragedy hits home. Does anybody know what hashtag that belongs to or what school I might be talking about? If you do, go ahead and drop it in the comments below. If you've heard that hashtag, never again. And you might know what school I'm talking about. Does anybody know? I'm going to wait a few more seconds to see if somebody might can find out the hashtag. I don't think I do. Okay, and that's all right because we're going to talk about it today. Today you're going to learn. So you're going to be getting some information here. I don't know. All right, and that's cool. All right, so you're going to be taking notes now. All right, here we go. We are talking about Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School. Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School. And so let's give you some facts about Marjorie Stoneman Douglas, okay? One of the deadliest mass shootings took place at Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School in Parkland, Florida on February 14th in 2018. So on Valentine's Day, one of the deadliest massacres took place at this high school in Parkland, Florida. All right? Second fact, the deadly school shooting left 17 students, faculty, and staff members killed and another 17 injured. Now people are saying, I'm starting to remember this, Douglas High School, I remember this. Oh wait, I think I heard of it, absolutely. The shooting reignited a nationwide debate over gun control. All right? All right. Fewer than 2 hours after the gunfire first broke out, authorities arrested 19-year-old Nicholas Cruz, who had formerly been a student at the school, and he had gotten expelled. So I want you guys to know. Mr. Williams told y'all about it? Absolutely. This, along with a lot of other shootings around the country that have taken places in schools, had started this movement. So we're going to be talking about that. So here you go.
I would just, before you move on, Ms. Radden, so if we are just taking notes so that we can remember what happened so that we can just follow along, I would just take a couple of notes about things that are really important from this first three paragraphs we have read. You might want to write down your five W's just so you can put some things under your five W's there. Who was involved? Where? What did happen? When did it happen? So take just a second, and then we can move on to the next part.
Absolutely. All right, so I'm going to take a look at a timeline, right, when this happened. Again, we know that it happened on Valentine's Day in 2018 in Florida. So let's take a look really. It's not on any page at this time. We're still in packet four, but it's not on any page. Band up, earn. All right? We're looking at causes because you are standing up for a cause. So if you missed last class, this is probably... we'll talk about that and we'll be able to get with you privately. Thank you. All right. So let's take a look. Timeline. At 2:19 p.m., the suspect in the shooting, then 19-year-old Nicholas Cruz, arrived at Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School via an Uber. He was carrying guns, an AK rifle, in a black bag, in an Uber. All right. Okay. And this was the scene of the high school.
Think about that when y'all complain about Mr. Walker checking your bags and making sure you don't have no book bags and stuff.
How about that? When you come to school. Mr. Walker, you can chime in. I know you're in the chat. So we're going to look on and let's see what happens then, okay? So that's 2:19. He walks into the school after getting out of an Uber. That's him, right? Now let me zoom in on his little picture. This is what the surveillance camera caught. And you can see the gun in his hand. At 2:21, he entered the building, building number 12, and walked into a stairwell with a black rifle bag. He opened fire within 15 seconds, firing into multiple classrooms. All right. So he comes into the building. One of the reasons why we have a lot of security, not sure what was going on during that time at his school. Oh, I remember this. Okay, yes. He walked in. He had gotten expelled, and he walked in, and he fired into classrooms.
Yeah, so this student entered into a stairwell, which means he didn't come into the main entrance. Probably one of his classmates came in there and opened the door for him. Or they had an open stairwell, so that's why our stairwells remain locked.
Yep. All right, we got that information down. Okay, moving on. At 2:22, the school's fire alarm goes off. All right, prompting students to begin evacuating. This is also when the first 911 call went out. So he arrives at 2:19, 2:21. He starts firing off rounds, 2:22, the school fire alarm goes off. That's what started the debate on putting metal detectors in schools too, right? I think we had metal detectors before then, but I think down in Florida, it might have been a little relaxed. And Mr. Israel, if you're in, and I know you have lived in Florida for a long time before coming to D.C., did they have metal detectors in schools there? If you could chime into the chat, that would be awesome. But you can see the students are all coming out at this point. Good morning, Miss Proctor. So this is the gunman. All right, Nicholas Cruz. All right. So what I found really interesting was this. After Cruz was shot and killed, both the students and school administrators, he dropped his AR-15 rifle and blended in with other students fleeing Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School. And then he casually walked to a nearby Subway and McDonald's to get a drink. So he dropped everything, came out like he was one of the students, and kept it moving, and went to Subway and McDonald's, and he got him something to drink. Wow. All right. Then we know that at 3:40, just not quite shy of 2 hours, a police officer finds him on a nearby street in the 1400 block of Wyndham Lakes Boulevard and South Coral Springs. And he surrenders to the police without resistance. They found him. That's right. They found him after he left the Subway and he was walking down the street. He fit the description of the gunman. And so a police officer approached him and he surrendered without resistance. However, he started to spaz out a little bit after he had gotten under arrest and they had cuffed him, that he started to actually vomit when it was said and done. I'm definitely going to post these notes on my page, for sure. All right. But I don't know if it's more so the notes of this that I want you to be focused on. I want you to be focused on their call or their cause to activism. Remember that their cause was never again. So now I'm going to ask you, why do you think they came up with the hashtag never again? Why do you think they came up with the hashtag never again? Knowing what you know now about this story. Sure, no problem. Why do you think they came up with the hashtag never again? I'm gonna wait for a couple of replies. Because they don't want the same situation to happen. Absolutely. I think they came up with the hashtag never again because they wanted to prevent stuff like this from happening. Absolutely. Absolutely. You guys are dead on point. All right. And the students were the ones that came up with this. And so I'm going to show you a short clip. All right. And you're going to take notes of the following. So what do the students want at this point that you know about the story? What do you think the students want from this? They want aging.
I think she meant again.
They want us to be more mindful of the situations like this. Absolutely.
Right, because this is not the first school shooting, right? By this time, we've had many school shootings that have occurred.
Absolutely.
That were really famous or infamous.
Absolutely. So we had Sandy Hook, which was elementary school, where over 20 first graders were shot and killed. We had Columbine out in Colorado that had 15 kids that were shot and killed. So when you're looking at this, and then there's several other school shootings around. But what the students wanted at this point was some stricter gun control, some gun reform is what they wanted. And they wanted to feel safe when they went to school. All right. So what we're going to do is I want you on your paper, what are they doing to achieve making sure that they are safe in their schools? What kind of things are they doing as you're watching the video clip? What impacts are these actions having and why? All right. So as you're working to look at the video, I want you to think about those questions and let's talk about those things when we come back. Again, I'm looking at questions 2 and 3.
Can we do a quick just reminder about the types of actions that people that we've talked about before? I know that we've talked about acts of civil disobedience. I don't know if you all remember that, where you kind of break the rules or break the law in order to protest against it. We talked about petitions. And
okay, I'm going to go ahead and flip the screen while you're talking.
Okay. And we talked about demonstrations, such as the hunger strikes and the sit-ins, you know, from the civil right, things like that. So those are at least three different things that we've already talked about that are ways of protesting causes that we care about.
Let me make sure my sound is all the way up. Okay. And here we go.
Dying. I will fight every single day. I just want to speak.
We call CS!
These students survived a shooting at their school. Now, they're leading a national movement for stricter gun control. Just days after the shooting, they called for school walkouts around the country, traveled to the Florida State Capitol.
You failed us!
And planned a nationwide march. Some of them can't even vote yet. It's clear these students are doing things differently. Here's how. Never Again is leveraging social networks to mobilize faster than most movements before it, according to experts who study the rise of social and political movements. 1 week after the shooting, the Never Again Twitter handle is verified and has more than 81,000 followers. In just a few days, student leaders have crowdsourced more than $3 million through online campaigns and celebrity donations. They're also handling their own crisis control by directly responding to critics.
I lost a best friend. Practically a brother. And I'm here to use my voice because I know he can't.
These survivors are presenting their personal stories of loss as part of their fight, converting grief into power by getting in the face of adults.
So, Senator Rubio, can you tell me right now that you will not accept a single donation from the NRA?
The Never Again movement wasn't formed in a vacuum. It's riding on the most recent wave of youth activism, which picked up speed around 2010. Student protests ebbed after the anti-war movement of the 60s and 70s. Young people today are getting involved to change systemic inequalities they were raised to believe had already been taken care of. The Dreamers, Students Against Sexual Assault, Occupy Wall Street, and the Black Lives Matter movement all had strong involvement by college-educated millennials. These groups have had modest success. President Barack Obama made sure campuses did more to investigate cases of sexual assault, and he later protected Dreamers from deportation.
You can come out of the shadows and get right with the law.
It's too early to tell if the Never Again movement will sustain the momentum it needs to bring tangible change. But it's an election year, so politicians might find their demands difficult to ignore.
All right. So I know that some of you guys were starting to write in the chat already, and I'm so excited about that. Definitely want to spend time. Uh-oh, 1 second. Technology. Let's do this. All right. So what kind of things were they doing to achieve their movement or make their movement propel forward? What type of things were they doing? And I noticed that some of us were saying that they were protesting. What else did you see them do? They had social networks. That is correct. This is what they were doing for their cause. Their cause was gun reform. All right. So someone said that they saw them protesting. They saw them using social networking. What else did they do? They made a Twitter account and replied personally to the critics. Absolutely. Absolutely. They had donations made, and they were made by celebrities and all of these people that came in. Absolutely. All right. What impacts are these things you think having on the gun reform movement? What do you think them protesting and coming and speaking at, you know, in D.C.? Because they did come here and they did a March for Our Lives movement. They went around the country. They did public rallies. Absolutely. So what kind of impact do you think that this is having? They were giving people things. What do you mean by that? What impact are these actions having? Is it making a difference? Yes or no? Them protesting caused people to come and listen to help them. I think it's good and bad because some people are all for it, but then there's the others who think otherwise. Okay. All right. And someone said yes. What impact, so are, what impact does this have? Accountability. I love it.
If you want
I didn't hear you, Mr. T.
Yeah, if you all know about social media, in order to be verified, I think you have to have a certain number of followers already. So they became verified in public media. That means that they were definitely getting a number of followers who were supporting them.
Absolutely.
So they're also bringing awareness.
This is having an effective and crucial impact towards school violence, right? And how things are perceived in schools now. And I wonder if at Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School now in Florida that things are shifted. Do they have metal detectors now? Are buildings locked or school buildings locked from the inside, you know, from the outside to come in? You know what I'm saying? Do they all have to come through a certain way? Did this change in this movement matter and make a difference? All right. Great job, you guys. All right. Which of all of the actions that you saw them do seem to be the most effective? Which one do you think was the most effective? You're going to put it in there. They did a couple of different things. Which one did you think was most effective? Somebody said protection. Which of these actions seem to be the most effective? Was it the protest? Is it the social media? Was it going and standing in front of people? Somebody said social media, protesting, the rallies. Okay. Health habits, healthy habits. No, we're talking about what we just saw, sweetheart. When they spoke out because people can see their emotions and how important it is to them. Absolutely. Again, we're talking about the video that we just saw. All right? Because remember, you guys have picked a cause, and maybe Money for Jordan, Healthy Habits was your cause. So you're looking at what people did in order to make a difference, right? So how are you going to parlay what you're doing or what cause you're after and make a difference for people? Okay, let's take a look at another question. Do you think the students will be able to make a lasting impact on this issue? So when I think about the kids at Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School and they're talking about gun reform, do you think that they are able to make a lasting impact on this issue? If yes, tell me why. And if no, tell me why not. Do you think that this never again movement will last beyond what we've just seen? I'll wait. There's no right or wrong answer. This is, again, your opinion. Do you think that what the students have done so far and what they're continuing to do to make their voices heard, do you think this will make a lasting impact on gun reform? No, because it's still happening. Discon 56 said, wait, say it again, please. All right, the question is
written there.
It's right here. Do you think the students will be able to make a lasting impact on this issue? If yes, why? If no, why not? Again, we're talking about gun reform and all of the things that the students have done thus far. Do you think that they'll be able to make a lasting impact on this issue? It's there. All right. I believe it's not going to last because there are always going to be school shootings. They might can't lower the chances of it happening. Yes, because I've seen a somewhat change in things throughout this movement. Okay. Yes, because if people, they keep making good points, then they will have more people listen to them. And I think that what students do will be remembered, but it has not made any large impact on gun control. Wow. Wow. All right. I'm going to move on to my next question. What roadblocks do you think they're going to run into? And I see Aesthetic JJ. Let me go ahead. You said yes to continue the movement and spread the word about gun reform to prevent it from happening to other schools effectively. Okay. So what kind of stumbling blocks or roadblocks are going to be that you think that this movement might run into? I agree with Jewel. Okay. Okay. Thank you for coming in. For those of you all that just coming into class started at 10 o'clock. Want to make sure we get in on time, but I'm happy for you. All right. What roadblocks do you think they're going to run into, you guys? They're going to run into guns? What do you mean by that? Can you expound on that?
Roadblocks, just for clarification, are barriers, right? So what challenges will they have as they are attempting to protest these shootings and gun control?
All right. People who use guns and believe they should have the right to use it anytime. Okay. Ignorance will be one if there is. Okay. And I believe that roadblocks will be their age and they're going to be treated like little kids by adults. Okay. And I think the large impact that will cause a roadblock is the government. Wow. By going against it, it might make most people mad, and ignorance from leaders in control. Exactly. One of the reasons why I asked the Do Now question this morning, what do you think you guys have a little bit different than we do? I think the age and getting the guns. Okay. All right. Good response. But why? All right. Mr. Hawkins to JD06D8. That's a great response. He says, but why? I think the large impact that will cause a roadblock is the government. Why would the government be the roadblock? People will use this as an excuse that staff should have guns.
That counters what they're doing.
Okay, to encounter what they're doing.
To counter, so right. Maybe to go against it. So he's talking about the debate of whether or not teachers should actually be armed with guns, or school staff members should be armed with guns.
Okay. right, these are great answers, you guys. I'm loving what I'm hearing right now, and I know that if we were in a classroom real time, it'd be a little different, and you guys would be able to kind of jump in. And also the lack of support. This con said to keep what they're doing because they think it's good for them, but they do think about everyone, or they don't think about everyone. Okay, I got it now. All right. And they might run into people who are against their actions and want them to keep their mouths shut, basically acting as this is not affecting them. Okay. All right. I'm going to kind of get to the bulk of my questions and kind of go over everything because we are running close to time. What suggestions do you have for them? For the activists at Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School, what kind of suggestions do you have for them to keep their movement in the forefront? You really can't think of anything better? Okay, I like it. I'm all right with that. What Jewel said. Okay. Is there any other suggestions that you might have for them? Do you think that they've used all their platforms to their ability? To keep fighting, all the officers outside of school. Do you have another class after this? You'll need to check the page. It would probably be one of your elective classes. With guns, though, keep on thriving to get their goal and to have safer schools, to protect the students. The suggestions I have for them is to keep their heads up and not give up. Okay. To keep going and make it something to stick, because it is really important to people worldwide. Make sure they choose their doors at the school. I like it. Keep being consistent and don't take no for an answer. Love, 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 love. Here we go. What reactions or questions do the student activism raise for you? What reactions or questions do they raise for you? Protect the students from violence. Are there any questions that what they've done that kind of are in your mind right now? Do you have any questions? If you could talk to one of them, What kind of questions, or what is your reaction to what they've done? Do you think it's been good? It's been a positive thing? So as you're thinking about that, if whether or not you like what they've done or any questions that they raise for you, I kind of want to bring us to this because we are almost at the close of our meeting today. But I want you to think about the cause that you wish to support. So the other day, a lot of people sent me posters about gun violence and about healthy habits and all of these different things. And if you haven't done your poster, you better make sure you do it. All right. So I want you to think about your platform that you chose. If you had a platform to tell others, how would you do it? Would you make a public service announcement? Maybe you might get a Twitter page or an Instagram page that talks specifically about your cause. Would you make a commercial? Create a rap, a poem, or a spoken word performance about your cause? Or maybe you might come up with another way. All right? So if you right now and you're looking at the screen, screenshot this really quickly. Go ahead and screenshot it. Could the Second Amendment be amended? If you don't know what that Second Amendment is, look it up and use what Mr. Pugh has taught. Okay. Love it. All right. Screenshot this page because I want you to be able to tell me based on that. So I know, for example, Aesthetic JJ sent me something and hers was about gun violence. Right. And so if I'm looking at what she sent me, and I'm telling you, Aesthetic JJ, would you at this point decide to make a public service announcement or maybe make a a page about it on social media? Would you make a commercial? Would you create a rap, a poem, or a spoken word about gun violence? Or would you maybe do something else? So when you come to class on Thursday, this is what I want you to be prepared to tell me which way you'd like to be able to do this. Okay. All right. Again, you should have screenshotted already. Let me go ahead and say this. And again, this will be posted up on my page. Excuse me. And in the story as well. So you'll be able to get to it at that time. And then lastly, if you have not done your poster, created your cause, you are now past due. You will not be eligible for full credit, but you'll be eligible for some credit. All right. Get your poster done. Get it to me today. Go to postermywall.com. Create a poster about your cause. If it's the environment, if it's animals, if it's gun violence, if it's police brutality, if it's about Black Lives Matter, whatever it is, get your poster done. Get it to me immediately. Save the poster on Poster My Wall, and then all you need to do is download it. It'll go into your camera roll if that's what you're doing it, or on your computer. And then I just need you to send me a DM or send me an email. This is going for grade 4, for term 4. So yes, it will. For those who ask question, can this make our grade lower? Mm-hmm. Yes, it can. Again, all of this is term 4. So everything else is off limits. Don't do it. You get a 0. And at the end of the term, if you didn't do the work, you get an F. It's real simple. All right. It was due yesterday at 9:00. I'm giving you a reprise. Send it in. Get it done. All right. Again, you won't be eligible for full credit, but you'll be eligible for a whole lot of credit if you get it done. All right. So you have two things to do. Think about a way that you want to get your cause known to the world that you're supporting, and have that ready to go. At least think about what you want to do, whether it's going to be a commercial, whether it's going to be a public service announcement. You want to create a rap. You don't have to have it done by Thursday. I just need to know which way you're thinking. And we'll discuss that when we come to class on Thursday. Mr. Thornton, you have anything you wish to say before I go ahead and end this live?
No, just to repeat, get your work done.
Get your work done. All right. At this point, I know that there are classes that are going on and you should be towards electives at 11:00. So I will not hold you. I love you guys. Thank you so much for jumping in. We'll see you later. Bye.